yards and 4 touchdowns. Mahomes is tied for the most TD passes this season at 7 and leads the league with 821 passing yards, almost 100 more than the next closest player. So, Shannon, got to start with you on this. Has Patrick Mahomes already locked up the MVP?
No, yeah, there's a lot of football left to play. But you gave him, but he the front runner. He the front runner, Skip Bailey.
He's in running away with.
Right now, he Usain Bolt. In the field trying to catch up with it.
Really?
How'd that work out for him?
Mm-hmm.
410 yards a game, 3.5 touchdowns. He's well on his way to matching the numbers that he put up last season. Mm. And just when you thought it was safe to come outside, just, oh, he's going to have a sophomore. Somebody said, he's going to have a sophomore slump. I ain't going to say who that was, Jenny. Sophomore slump. You know, it's a sophomore slump.
Have the playoffs started?
Whoa, Skip Bayless, it's not your turn. I didn't ask you to intervene. Jenny, I was talking to Jenny.
Yeah.
Now I'm talking to you.
You're always talking to
me. Yeah, I'm talking to you.
I won't listen.
Now, look, he put up huge numbers without the game's best deep threat. I know you like Michael Gallup, but Tyreek Hill is the game's best deep threat.
I'll give you that.
And he put up those numbers because what happened, Sammy Watkins had this huge game in Jacksonville. So now Raiders are like, we're going to roll coverage to Sammy Watkins. And now you let Robinson go for
$172. Went crazy.
And then you let Mecole.
Every time I looked up, number 11 was catching another one.
And you forgot about Mecole Hardman.
Oh, dude,
he ran 4.33. He got speed to burn.
Yeah.
So they got all these receivers that can run 4.3. And then you got Kelce. Now, the defense, I believe, Skip, the defense is better than it was last year. But they're not elite. So they're going to be into a lot of shootouts. And so he's going to put up these huge numbers. I wouldn't be surprised that within the probably next 2 or 3 weeks, he has a 500-yard game. That's coming. That's coming. I was kind of hoping the Raiders, like, score.
Huh.
So that way, you know, because I think he got a little careless. He hit him with a no-look again, too, Skip. You ain't see it. He hit him with a no-look. He was like, ready. Take that away. Oh, you thought I was throwing it over here? Nah.
And then you pose.
Yeah.
You pose the camera like.
Yeah. Huh? And, hey, he shoot layups like
we
this. Ain't never layups out there.
It's a
layup. Yeah. Got it going.
I think it's like an easy three.
Easy bucket. Yeah. Easy bucket. You know what it is, Skip, baby.
Can you explain what he did? Like,
which part?
In that game Sunday, he throws for 278 and 4 touchdowns in the second quarter. And then the rest of the game, he was kind of like Eli Ordinary.
Oh, don't do that, Skip. We hadn't done the damage. Ain't no sense. Come on, Skip.
I don't know. The rest of the game he threw for 165. Not bad, but not great.
I've seen Dak Prescott play entire games and not throw for 165. That ain't none of my business, Skip.
That's
I don't even know why
true.
I brought
you
that
haven't
up.
Seen
I'm
that.
Sorry. I'm sorry. I shouldn't even brought that up.
Yeah.
I know that's a touchy subject for you.
Well, obviously, Dak Prescott is right in the middle of this MVP race so far. Now, maybe that will tail off because his quarterback and coach and play caller, they don't play that way.
Okay.
This is a balanced attack in Dallas, and that's why Dallas is going to win so many games.
Well, I can assure you, if they had Zeke Elliott, because remember, when they had Kareem Hunt led the league in rushing.
Yep.
He was top 2 or 3 last year when he got suspended. Well, this is what it calls for. We got Shady McCoy. LeSean McCoy, he's not the McCoy that he was in Philly or his first year in Buffalo.
Yep.
Williams is a very versatile dual threat, but he's not the runner that Kareem Hunt is. So sometimes, Skip, you have to do, look, we got the guy. You trade up to get this guy right here, this is what you do. See, when you got a quarterback like that, you don't pay $50 million for a running back.
Okay.
It's Tom Brady. They got no $50 million running back. Do we?
Okay. So, before I get to the guts of this discussion, quick point of order. I did say before the year started, I thought Ben Roethlisberger would be a dark horse MVP candidate.
Yeah.
He just suffered the weirdest quarterback injury I have ever heard. I'm pretty sure, even though they're not being specific, he's having Tommy John surgery, and quarterbacks don't have Tommy John injuries where you tear a ligament in your elbow, right?
Right.
But doesn't it sound like that's what happened? I think he tore it late in training camp because that guy I saw at New England on opening Sunday night, I told you the next day, I said, I can't recognize him.
Right.
He couldn't throw it 10 yards. It looked like Peyton Manning coming off the neck problems.
Right. Especially last year when he ended up going to the bench.
Yeah. Right, that guy. Well, that's what Ben looked like at New England. And then they said he tried to practice, then he couldn't practice. And then he goes out there against Seattle, and they did lead at 10-7 at halftime when he went out just before halftime. But he just couldn't throw it anymore.
Nope.
And so now he's got to have reattached ligament, and he's gone for the year.
Right.
Okay, so he's out. And that leaves
Andrew Luck.
Yeah, that's okay. Fair enough. Yeah, that's another possible candidate. And that brings us to the guy you still will give no credit to, and it's the guy up in Foxborough, and he's still standing at age 42, yeah. And he's off to one of his best starts of his career.
Is it better than Mahomes got going?
Yes, he is. He's
Did
you even ask that blasphemous question?
Skip.
Seriously.
Skip, right now, my homeboy, the best thing going.
Okay, well, he might be the most entertaining.
No, he's the best thing going.
He's like one-man globetrotter.
No, he's the best thing going.
He's like
right now.
Meadowlark Lemon playing quarterback, right?
Skip, he's the best thing going right now. You know that and I know that.
I do not know that because the game, the name of the game is winning.
Yeah.
And nobody can win like that guy in Foxborough.
Oh, what's his record?
And if A.B. does stay eligible for the whole year, he's going to be right in the middle of this MVP race.
Yeah, and guess what? Sheeta coming back. Tyreek Hill coming back.
Okay.
So now you got four guys outside.
Okay.
Three guys that can run 4-3 and Travis Kelce.
The truth is, both Kansas City and New England play incredibly easy by NFL standards schedules. You can't tell me Kansas City's schedule isn't just about as easy as New England's.
What they got?
Okay, so they do have Baltimore this Sunday. Yeah. It's at home. Then they have Green Bay at home, and they have Minnesota at home. They can win those games.
Yeah.
And late in the year, very late, they have to go to Chicago on December 22nd. But the key game, the game of probably two unbeaten teams, if I'm reading the tea leaves correctly, will occur on December the 8th in Foxborough. It's now scheduled for 4:25 kick Eastern time. And I think we're going to have undefeated Chiefs visiting undefeated Patriots.
Wow.
And not only will home field advantage be on the line for the postseason, but MVP, I think, will be up for grabs that night.
Hmm.
And all I know is the quarterback you still give no credit to, somehow he outplayed my homeboy twice last year.
No, he didn't,
year.
Skip,
yes, he
baby.
Did.
Skip, look at the numbers. The numbers say otherwise.
Did you see the fourth quarter that he put on at Foxborough in that Sunday night game?
But did my homeboys have the game tied? Did he have
which,
that game?
Which game?
The game in Foxborough. And Tom Brady came back and got a game-winning field goal.
Yeah.
Okay, my homeboy had the lead when he left the field. Tom Brady went and tied the game in regulation and won it in overtime. Mm. How did he outplay him? Tom Brady threw two picks.
Yeah.
One of the end zone was horrible.
What did Tom throw for in the fourth quarter alone, 130?
But what did my homeboy do for the game?
Who won that game? Help
see,
me out.
You go. See, that's, you see what you did?
Well, that's what you always do to me.
No, I don't.
Yeah.
No. I ain't saying nothing about no QBR. But this notion that Tom Brady outplayed him, no. His team won. But just because your team win doesn't mean you outplayed the other guy.
Who won the AFC Championship game? Who took over the overtime and converted three straight third and tens? That is impossible.
Was my homeboy playing safety?
Should have been.
He had to leave. Hold up. When he left the field, because this is what you do to me when we talk about Tom Brady.
Mm.
When Tom Brady left the field against Eli the first time, you said they had a 14-10 lead. That's what you told me. When Tom Brady left the field the second time against Eli, they had to leave. That's what you told me. So what happened?
All I know is Tom Brady just keeps winning Super Bowls. So he's now 6 out of 9 Super Bowls that he's won. And this kid in Kansas City, he's got a chance.
My homeboy coming.
He's got a chance. And he's come nowhere. He's done nothing yet. Has he played in a Super Bowl? Has he played in one?
I mean, Skip, this
and you're already crowning him the best quarterback
Skip,
in football?
It's only his third year.
He can throw the best no-looks. Tom Brady would never even think about throwing a no-look.
The man just turned 24 and already got an MVP on this
belt. Okay, all right. And he's got how many trophies?
Skip, the man, this is only his third year.
Okay, well, so?
Oh, because Brady won in his second year, anybody that didn't win a Super Bowl in his second year, trash.
Hmm. So, let's see. Who's fourth in QBR so far? Oh, it's Tom Brady. I'll give you this. My homeboy is third in QBR.
Oh, okay.
Who's first? Dak Prescott. But we knew that.
Okay, who's first in yards?
Yeah.
Touchdown. Like you say, the wow factor,
He's got all that.
Box office.
You know what he's got on his side? Andy Reid.
No. Oh, you got Kellen Moore.
Remember that quote in The Athletic about Andy Reid? He's got that guy. What was that guy's name who played for him in Philly thinking he's a Hall of Famer, right? Donovan.
That was dirty. That was a low blow, Skipper. You know it.
Well, okay. But there's some truth to it where Andy Reid went and found this kid and traded up to get this kid. So he's going to try to make him the MVP every year.
Now you're seeing what this offense.
Can you go win a Super Bowl with this kid? I say no.
Now you're seeing what this offense could be when they had check down Alex in it, checking the ball down.
Okay.
He ain't trying to check it down. He's trying to throw them 60-yard bombs over your head.
Yep, and he's turned into a caricature. He's going to throw them left-handed, behind his back, and no looks.
Who got more interceptions? Dak Prescott or my homeboy?
Mm. Dak's got one.
Oh, my home, how many of my homeboy got?
Yeah, and it wasn't Dak's fault.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault.
The receiver got two hands.
He threw it.
Yeah, okay.
Put it in the chair.
Okay.
Put it right between the one and the eight. Yeah, it's a catch.
Sometimes you have to escape a rush, and he got a real furious pass rush.
That's how my homeboy threw that no look. He had to escape the rush.
Yeah.
And give him that right
okay.
there.
Okay. Mm. I give you this. He's far more entertaining, if that's what you want to watch.
Better.
He's got a flying circus. He's got Andy Reid, Andy Reid is the ringmaster in Kansas City.
He's the best quarterback going right now.
Hurry,
right now.
Step right up and see Patrick Mahomes throw a no look.
In the first 3 weeks of the season.
You like that, Shannon?
He's the best quarterback going right now. Hottest thing going, look at Mahomes, boy. Got that old suit, diamond all up, paid.
Ooh. We haven't had back-to-back MVP since Peyton Manning in 08.
If anybody could
do it. Decade.
The truth is, he's all you got on this show.
What? Well, Mahomes, boy?
Yeah.
That's kind of harsh, Skip.
I got plenty.
That's kind of right.
That's all he's got?
It's all said and done. You look, like you said, hold on. You just said we got a long way to go.
We do.
And you already celebrate like the Cowboys. Are the Cowboys the NFC? What a confetti.
Not yet.
Anybody drop confetti down on the Cowboys for the NFC?
Who likes my chances of winning 5 more cases of Diet Dew because the Cowboys are going to make the playoffs? And Shannon says, no, they will not make the playoffs.
We'll see.
Yep.
Have they officially clinched the playoff spot right now?
You must go home and stick pins in your doll trying to get them hurt, right?
No.
You got your X-Man Xavier Woods doll. You stuck it right in his ankle. You got your Gallup doll.
I don't need that. I don't need that because sooner or later, that old shooting star that you got, it got to come down sooner or later.
Okay.
You got a shooting star right now. He played good.
He's out of his mind.
We got to say happy birthday to my homeboy. It is his birthday today.
Hey, happy birthday.
Was it really?
24. And already got an MVP?
Yeah. He's a Virgo. No wonder I like this guy. I feel that makes all the sense in the world.
Dak go get an MVP?
He might.
He should. He's 26.
He's going to get multiple trophies.
We got a lot of football to play.
Lombardi.
A lot of football to play. Yep. We're going to move on to some college football.
Yes,
Will Nick Saban regret giving up on Jalen?
He already does.
No, he did.